So, I just wanted to talk about my helmet today, which is the IXS Trigger FF. I bought it around 1.5 years ago, and for now it did a pretty good job, not a perfect job. But that's what I want to talk about today, and let's start with the price, like always. It comes in at around 120 to 180 euros, it really depends where you order it. I even saw it for like 230, 240 euros when you order it straight from the website, but that's definitely not necessary. I paid 170 euros last year, but that was also because we had a helmet shortage in Germany because of Corona. I hope it's not icy. Nope, not really. Okay. And I also couldn't really choose the color, but I like this lime green kind of. It's also a little safety feature, I'd say, just to make sure you get seen. And the helmet comes in at around 600 grams, they say. I got the size SM, which is the second biggest out of three, or the second smallest out of three different sizes. And mine weighs 658 grams after the modifications I did to this helmet, which is the Insta360 or the GoPro mount on top here. And it's also the wind reduction mod I did, I would call it like that. My head measures around 58 centimeters, the head circumference when I'm right. And that's actually a really bad size. If you have this size, it's like the worst size you can have, because my helmet, the SM, goes from 54 to 58. And I ordered the L, the ML and the SM to check both. And I didn't like the size of the ML. It was a little too big from my opinion, but the SM was a little too small, but I really liked it. So what I did is I wrapped tape around these cushions on my left and my right chin, and with this mod it was perfect, it was good. I'm happy with that. And the other mod I did is, which brings me to the next topic, listening to music or listening to navigation system. I always have my right in-ear plugged in, not my left one, because I want to hear the beeps and everything that's going on if somebody wants to pass me from the left. Anyways, the right one I'm always using, it always had this wind noise because the wind was going straight into the helmet and just hitting my earbuds or my earbud. I just took a little bit of these other cushions because it comes with two different sizes of cushions for your chin. I already got the smaller one. And just wrapped it around as well, just to reduce the wind, and that definitely helps. And with this mod I reduced the wind noise quite significantly, and I'm happy with that, but obviously other helmets would be better if it comes to listening to music using your earbuds. So many joggers. And the next thing I want to talk about is the visor, which is this one, which got a little loose just 2 weeks ago after 1.5 years, and that was not a big deal. Hello, doggy. Hello, doggy too. No, that wasn't a big deal at all. I just used a screwdriver. It was like a 10 second fix. Ooh, take a look. Then what you got on this helmet is this adjustable wheel on the back, which is perfect. I like it. It's nice. It does its job. Nothing to complain about that. And something which I really, really love about this helmet. I'm pretty sure there are other helmets. My hand is getting cold. With this kind of closing system, the way you open and close your helmet on here, it's, you can do it one-handed, like super easily, It's just so great how it opens and closes. It's just perfect. I couldn't really imagine a life without it, to be honest. It's just a perfect system. So that's what I really, really like about that helmet. So what I don't like about this helmet is this plastic protection. It kind of peels off by now. So how you can see here, it's peeling off, but that's not a big deal, I would say. This helmet is supposed to protect you and also maybe look nice, but that's probably a factor which is not the most important. So all in all, in the summer it's great, in the winter it's hate. That's how I would call it. In the summer it's a great helmet. You kind of forget that you were wearing a helmet or that you are wearing a helmet. So in these situations like supermarket, wherever, just waiting for 2 minutes, you don't feel like taking off the helmet because it's just not a pain. You really forget about it. In the winter though, you don't forget about wearing a helmet because it's so fucking cold with these air vents. Like, they really do a good job in the summer, but in the winter, there's not really, it's probably the coldest helmet you can get. So it depends on the region where you are living in. In Germany, I would say it's a good helmet because I ride in the summer way more than I do in the winter. So if I would need to decide for one helmet, I would definitely get this one again and not a closed full-faced helmet. And that's kind of it with the video already. Yeah, I really recommend this helmet for the summer. I think the rate is just great. I borrowed these glasses from my neighbor. I'm thinking about buying one because it definitely helps not freezing all of your body parts. At least your eyes are not freezing as much. It's minus 2 degrees. And next time I will probably upload a video to my Bigode M10-4, which should arrive in 1.5 to 2 weeks. And then there will be the Bigode T4 I ordered as well, which should arrive in February, they said, at my e-wheels. The batch 2, I really didn't want to get the batch 1. So that's what I want to talk about the next time, is the Bigode T4, just unboxing and just first impressions. I'm really looking forward to this reel. I think it will be a great reel. I think it would be a super, super fun reel. See you the next time.